In this video, I want to help you out. I want to show you how easy it is to find and report copycats on Redbubble so that you can stop them from making a profit off of your designs and hopefully get more sales. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and I've seen a lot of people copy my designs. There's lots of copycats out there, and I'm talking about pixel for pixel copycats. I'm not just talking about people that take the idea that you have and do it their own style. I'm talking about people who totally just rip off the designs and sell it as their own without any addition or anything like that. Now, this happens on a lot of POD sites. This time I'm going to focus on Redbubble, but it doesn't mean that Redbubble is the only POD site that has copycats. There's copycats on Etsy, there's copycats on Amazon, there's copycats everywhere. In this video, I'm going to focus on Redbubble because they have a special way to report. Every pod site has a different way to report copycats. I'm going to show you the Redbubble way. So I'm going to show you in this video how to find copycats, at least the way that I do it, and where to report it and how to do it, how easy it is, where to find the forms and everything like that. So let's get into Redbubble right now and I'll show you how to do this. So here I am on Redbubble. You can see Redbubble, redbubble.com. I'm on my shop right now, Detour Shirt Shop. And if you scroll down on your shop, you'll see like your top designs will be right here, the most relevant. You could also do things like best-selling. And that's what people do when they copycat. They look for your best-selling stuff and copy them because they know that those are selling and they hope that if they do the same thing, if they copy your designs, people are gonna be looking for these and then they'll get a sale as well. So that's the mentality of the copycatter, right? They're gonna just, with as little work as they can do, copy the ones that sell the best and hope that they get a piece of that too without doing much work. So copycatters are lazy. And because they're lazy, it's easy to find them because what they do is, let's just take this example, the top one of mine. This word right here, this phrase, this title, they're gonna also copy the phrase. So not only are they gonna copy the design, they're gonna copy this phrase. So if I type in the search bar on Redbubble, in this case, Moab, Utah Arch Vintage Sunset, I'll bet you I'll find a copycat. So let's do it. Moab Utah Arch Vintage Sunset. Okay, so that's my long keyword title. I'm gonna hit search. You use whatever yours is, whatever your top selling is, you do this on your own. Type in the at least five words if your title is longer than five words, and then hit search. And it's gonna take a little while, but you're gonna see mine is the top result, right? And again, that's how they look for the top results. So one thing to notice, look at the design, the colors, the fonts. We're gonna see if we can find an exact match, and I'm sure we will. So there's one right here, it's not an exact match, it's very similar, but it's not the same font. But if we look here, the exact same font, the exact same layout as this one, right? Let's see. So here's another one. Exact same font, exact same. Let's see. Again, we'll scroll down some more. Here's one. Here's some more, right? With the hexagon that are not mine. Let's see. That's Detour Shirts. Again, I've done a few. Here's another one, right? So I got a lot to report here. Let's scroll down again. That's mine, that's mine, that's mine. So let's go and report this one right here. This looks exactly like mine, so we're gonna click on it. And again, they took the, not only did they take the design, but the whole phrase, right? Moab, Utah, Arch, Vintage Sunset, right? Look at it right here. Another thing copycats like to do is to tag spam. So of course they were already breaking the rules on taking pixel for pixel stuff. Of course they're gonna tag spam too by doing Utah, Utah, Utah to try to get up there in the rank. So you can look for that as well. The nice thing about Redbubble is this right here. You can report content and you can do copyright infringement. So let's take a look at both of them. I'm gonna open these in different tabs. So I'm gonna right click, open a new tab. right click, open a new tab. So you can see the difference what these are. So first, the report content. You can report inappropriate content, but this is not for copyright infringement. So you can see here, none of these is copyright infringement. This is just for bad things like violence or pornography or inappropriate stuff. So this is just inappropriate content is how that works. But that's not exactly what we want to do. So let's go to the other one, which was this copyright infringement, right? Report content is just for inappropriate stuff. Copyright infringement is the one you want to do. So scroll down when you find Copycat all the way to copyright infringement. It will open up this right here. You can read all these things, what it is, but what you want to do is click on this right here, notice and take down report. Okay. So let's do that. So this will open up a new page. You can fill out this right here. And I'm going to put my name here, right holder's name, my name again, Redbubble username. In this case, I'm going to put Detour Shirts. My email address, you would put that here. You don't need the physical address. You can if you want to. It's not required. The required ones are here with the asterisks. And URLs, this is required. So what I would do is come up here, go all the way to the top just to make sure that this is the right one. Double click on this and then do Command C or copy and come back here and I would put this right there. And then description of intellectual property, you can say what it is. So mine would be Moab design in a hexagon, whatever, right? And describe it. Then you would go to your site, come here, click on this one. So you find your design that they're copying, double click here, Command C, come back to this part and put this in here. After you describe what it is, Command V. So you have what it is, Moab design in a hexagon with vintage sunset, fill it out. You could also add a file if you want to. I don't know how much that helps, it's not required. But then you would click these. In good faith, yes, I know this is my design. It's a pixel for pixel copy. Make sure that you own the rights if you did it. I know I drew this one. I drew this by hand. I made it all in Affinity Designer, so I know this one is mine. I didn't buy it from anywhere else. So then you would submit this here and report it. And then you'll get an email back from Redbubble saying that they got it. And eventually they will take it down. So sometimes it takes longer than a week, but they'll get it within a few days. They're gonna take a look at it, and then within about a week, they'll take stuff down. So that's how easy it is to report on Redbubble. Unfortunately, again, like I said, there's so many things. If you go on Redbubble right now, so I've been doing some cleanup on Redbubble, and you can see this one also, my famous Corgi is being stolen right here by other people. I'm finding a lot. Every quarter I go in and just do some of my top sellers, and you can see that, you know, again, they're the same. Corgi eating ramen. They take the designs. They not only take the designs, but they take the title. So they're pretty easy to find on Redbubble, but it's just a pain to report them over and over again. I hope that Redbubble can find a way to make sure that they know that it's your design, and then whenever somebody else tries to upload the exact same design, they can find it and kind of report it themselves. So unfortunately, if you're in the pod business, this happens a lot to everyone. This is kind of part of the business because it's so easy for people to do this. People are looking for a quick way to make sales, so they, you know, do the lazy way and do it. So hopefully this video is really helpful for you so that you can find the copycats on Redbubble and report them. Redbubble's pretty good at removing the stuff, but again, there's so many copycats that it's hard for them to keep up. So just give them some time and they'll do it. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video was really helpful for you. Now you know how to find and report copycats on Redbubble. If this video is helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. It really helps in the algorithm. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what pod sites have you found copycats of your design? I talked about Redbubble, but there may be others that you found on. Let me know that in the comments. Have you found it on Amazon or Etsy or Redbubble or TeePublic? Let me know that in the comments. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos for print on demand, make sure to click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.